Hachette Audio presents Sci-Fi Junior High 2, Crash Landing. Written by John Martin and Scott Seegert. Read by Nate Begle. This program includes a Mac and PC compatible PDF of bonus material.
Day 1. 1. 329 quadrillion miles from Earth. Sciria Strati Fibrinocularius Junior High School.
All right, everybody, gather round. Remember yesterday when I told you we'd be climbing something tomorrow? Something no one has ever been able to make it to the top of in all the years I've been teaching gym classes? Well, today is tomorrow. And what we'll be climbing is this rope right here.
Yeah, Coach Ed. I remember yesterday, all right. And so does my buddy, Randell. That's when he came up with the idea to make this my one big thing. The thing I'll always be remembered for. Kelvin Klosmo. The guy who made it to the top. Incredible! Unbelievable! Awesome! And so cute, too.
And I hope you all took my advice and did a few extra push-ups before you went to bed last night, because you're going to need every bit of strength you can muster to get up this baby. It's wobbly, it's slippery, and it's over 30 feet high.
You see, we figured that if I become known for something really cool, everybody will forget about how I tried to fake being super brilliant when I first got to this new school at the far end of the galaxy. And then maybe they'll quit calling me genius. You know, the sarcastic kind. Like when you call a short kid Paul Bunyan, or a shy kid Mr. Personality. At least, that's the theory. The teasing is getting pretty unbearable.
Now let me give you a few pointers. I don't mean to brag, but I was the Delpnir District Pole Climbing Champion back in 87, so I know what I'm talking about.
I asked Randell, if no one else ever made it to the top, why did he think I could? I'm no athlete. I mean, if my backpack's full, I have trouble climbing into the shuttle bus in the morning. He told me not to sweat it, that he had it all taken care of.
First, you get yourself a good grip. Then, you pull yourself up like so. Flomp! Zagnart!
Awesome! I brought the duct tape again.
Okay. Any questions?
Yeah. Are we allowed to keep our arms attached to our bodies?
Sure. If you want to do it the easy way. Now, who's going to go first?
Danny Diptera. He's known for his sticky fingers. And I don't mean I got some jelly on my hand sticky. I'm talking, I dumped a gallon of glue on myself and then fell into a vat of tar sticky. I tried playing catch with him once. He was great at catching, but he couldn't throw the ball back. And no matter how many times he says, "Lay it on me, dude," you do not want to high-five Danny Diptera. Trust me on that one. He should be able to scramble up that rope no problem, no matter how slippery it is. Danny makes it to the 7-foot mark and slides back down. It takes 10 minutes to unstick him from the cushions. Zot volunteers to go next. She's the best athlete I've ever seen. If anybody can do this, she can. Come to think of it, maybe I should have just asked her to wear a Kelvin mask for her climb to the top. Zot makes it to the 10-foot mark, and that's it. What's this rope made out of anyway? Vaseline? I nudge Randell. Great idea you've got here. I'll be lucky to get my feet off the ground. Randell hands me something. What are these?
Anti-gravity discs. My mom uses them to arrange the furniture in our live space. Stick them in your boots. When it's your turn on the rope, just kick your feet together and they'll turn on. You'll practically fly to the top of that rope.
You know what? Randell might actually have something here. I shove the discs into my boots and volunteer to go next. After spitting into my hands and rubbing them together, for effect, I grab onto the rope and kick my feet together. And suddenly, I feel weightless. I start to climb. Dang, this might actually work. Climbing Kelv! Climbing Kelv! Now that's more like it. Goodbye, genius. Hello, Climbing Kelv. Uh-oh. Kelvin?
Huh?
What? What the heck?
Wait a minute. Huh?
Floosh!
Boo! It's the drifting doofus!
Nice try, genius.
I'm on it, coach.
Drifting doofus! Drifting doofus! Drifting doofus!
Well, this is embarrassing. Ugh. The drifting doofus? Are you kidding me? Thanks a lot, Randell.
Hey, it's better than genius.
Really, Randell? Is it? That's like saying a stubbed big toe is better than two stubbed big toes. It might be a little bit better, but it still hurts. A lot.
Hey, look, everybody. It's the drifting doofus genius.
And that hurts like five stubbed big toes. 2. Later that day, Sharndor is the fifth planet from the sun in the Dubali system. Its population is 12 billion, and its main exports are Flubin ore and Grismac crystals.
Excellent, Kelvin. Kelvin? Kelvin!
Poof! Who? What? When? Yikes. I must have been daydreaming again. Nowadays, that's the only time I answer anything right.
Who is you, Mr. Clausmo? What is telling the class how many there are, and when is right this instant?
How many what there are? Man, I hate galactic geography. Looks like it's guess time again. Should I go high or low this time? Low, I think. 3?
3? Am I to understand, Mr. Clausmo, that you believe there are only 3 planets in the entire Milky Way galaxy? Your own solar system has 8 all by itself. 9, if you count Pluto. Would you like to take another stab at it?
Of course I wouldn't. Problem is, when Professor Plutz asks a question like that, it sounds like you have a choice, but you really don't. At least I know what the question is now, even if I don't have a clue about the answer. Who knows? Maybe I'll get lucky. Let's see. I know the space station has families from over 200 different planets living aboard it. So, there must be at least that many. Add in a few more here and there, and I should at least be pretty close. 300?
Actually, Mr. Clausmo, there are over 100 billion planets in our galaxy.
Oops.
Hey, genius! Not bad. You were only off by about 100 billion. Ha!
That's Dorn. I have no idea why he hates me so much, but at least he hasn't stuffed me into my helmet lately. Not since Grimney wadded him up in that ball of desks a couple months ago. Grimney hates bullies. And there's that word again. Genius. And like I said, they aren't using it the way they did when I first got here, when everybody thought I really was one. And why wouldn't they? My parents are the top 2 scientists on the entire planet Earth. It only makes sense that their son would bump that up a notch and be even smarter, right? It's only natural to assume that he would be what I like to call a mighty mega super genius. And I sure wasn't going to be the one to let on any differently, especially since it made me a pretty big deal around school. I mean, people expected it. But a guy can only pretend to be smart for so long, and now the cat's out of the bag, and my reputation's taken a real nosedive. I mean, talk about your crash landing. Everybody knows I'm pretty average, and After that last answer, maybe not even that. That's why I'm getting the other genius treatment. I'm not giving up hope, though. I'm sure my brain power is going to kick in at some point. Well, pretty sure. Actually, I guess desperate wishing is more where I am at this point. For now, though, maybe I can still save face. I actually thought you meant inhabited planets, Professor.
If I had meant inhabited planets, Mr. Clausmo, I would have let you know as much.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.